Hi everyone, it's me Lakshita here from Circuit Digest, and today in this video I'm going to tell you what is a breadboard. So basically a breadboard helps in building electronic circuits without actually soldering components together. There are connections inside breadboard which acts like wire. So now let's learn more about breadboard. So here's our breadboard. In this breadboard, these upper two rows are the power rails which are horizontally connected with each other. Apart from this, these holes are also known as connecting points and are connected in group of five. That means these rows are connected together. So now let's learn how a breadboard actually works. These holes of breadboard allow you to easily push the leads or metal legs of a component like LED into them. So here's our LED. All we have to do is push it into the holes like this. Just always make sure not to connect any component in the same row, otherwise it may damage your component due to short circuit. We can simply connect our resistor like this. So here's our IC. Always connect your IC in this way. If we'll connect the IC in the same column, it may get short-circuited. So now we are going to learn how to make a simple LED circuit on this breadboard. For making this LED circuit, here we have 9-volt battery. All we have to do is connect its negative terminal to the negative part of the power rail and the positive terminal to the positive part of our power rail. After connecting this, here we have our LED. Always remember the shorter leg is the negative one and the longer leg is the positive one. Just make sure to connect it in different rows. Now here's our resistor. All we have to do is connect its positive terminal to the positive part of our battery just like this. Now we'll connect this jumper wire to the negative terminal of our LED and the negative terminal of the battery. Just in this way. And here's our LEDs light up. So that's how we make connections on breadboard. Now we'll move towards the mistakes that every beginner should avoid. First, avoid changing connections when power supply is on, as it might accidentally create short circuits. Second, don't make high voltage or AC voltage connections on breadboard. Third, don't build high current circuits on breadboard. And the last one is that avoid building circuits that are prone to electrical noise like audio circuits or high accuracy measurement circuits. So that's all about the breadboard. I hope you learned and enjoyed this video. Hope to see you soon in another such video. Till then, peace out.